I'll be keeping time. And
thank you, Angela, for coming this evening. It was very, very a wonderful, wonderful experience. Could you ask yourself, why do people self-medicate themselves so much and in such increasing numbers these days?
Well, I think that question has to do with a dilemma that I was asking you to reflect on earlier. And that is to say the relationship between the pharmaceutical industry and the ideological representation of drugs as panaceas and the availability of street drugs to certain communities who do not have the opportunity to have access to doctors, to psychiatrists, and other doctors who would prescribe psychotropic medication for them. I think that, I don't have a definitive answer to that question, but I think it's certainly a question that we have to reflect on. And that would perhaps also help us to recognize why it is that people are brought under the control of the criminal justice system, oftentimes for engaging in behavior that is harmful to them. But then, of course, there's the question of the decriminalization of drugs. And we know that some drugs that have been previously illegal are not nearly as dangerous as pharmaceutical drugs. And of course, I live in a state where medical marijuana has been legal for a very long time. And I know that some of the most dangerous effects of drugs are from pharmaceuticals, like oxycodone and others. So I think it's really important to try to pull that apart and recognize the ideological content of these assumptions that we are asked not to question. But thank you very much for your question. That's definitely a beginning.
Good evening, Dr. Davis. My name is Emily. I'm a senior in American Studies and Women's and Gender Studies. And I actually, one of my good friends, he graduated last year. He graduated from the same program of American Studies and Women's Studies. He's working in Little Rock right now, and he is a huge fan of yours, and he wishes he could have been here tonight. But he's working for City Year, so he couldn't make it. But he sent me quite a lengthy question for you. So just bear with me while I...